But it definitely could be handy for their offense.
And there we go. We got Cine and Fleet running sniper. And apparently three snipers on attackers.
Oh well, they got some options if one of the snipers isn't having a good night. So you're gonna have to give me a pro tip here, Volk. I know I can do 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 to switch between the players, but how do I switch between the players on the opposite team?
Hold Alt and press numbers.
Yes, too good, mate.
And F for free cam. She went there because I got the camera.
True.
I'm in control here.
Oh, I know.
Unusual, we got a rhino, another rhino on the other side, a Fletcher, I like seeing Fletcher, an Ardy, everything else is pretty normal. Oh no, there's red eye. Need to check who what there is.
So thanks to Precious HUD, I won't actually know who I'm specking. Which isn't much fun, but we'll still be able to keep an eye on the action.
Who you're specking should pop out the person on the left hand or right hand side.
You've obviously done this before, Flog.
Witface is what the. Got your med pack right here.
So if the defender's current classes are the lineup for the first phase D, it's pretty standard.
We got two medics, a Scott, well, Fops, a soldier, and an NG. Should probably get around to using their proper names one day.
Well, they are the proper names, man. So yeah, I'd anticipate probably the aura and the frag combo up in the apartments, and then the rest just sort of milling around behind flag, just doing what they can. Offensively, it'll be interesting to see what atmosphere have in store. This can be a really hard phase to attack on if the defenders get set up. Can be set up any map. It's if IRAXON keeps something, keep it together, I guess. Get some nice scrappy reactions going on, then atmosphere could have some work.
Tonight we have attackers as atmosphere and redux as defenders for position 5 on the cybergamer pro league. Chosen terminal for the first map. Where's Rico? There's Rico.
Got bullets for you.
Can't go wrong with Rico. He'll always put on a show.
Yeah, you can say that again. So it looks like he's pushing up to Balk, so we'll see what he's got in store for their apartment defense. So Rico pulling out the LMG doesn't do much good for him though, because he gets taken down with some crossfire. But very interesting to see him rolling an LMG fragger.
Yeah, I guess he didn't like the M4 change.
Maybe he found it too easy to aim with the M4.
Bah.
So that's pretty good reaction from RX. I mean, you know, that was obviously their opening salvo when they managed to shut that down, get a clean wipe on atmosphere. That bodes well. Let's just see what's coming up next.
Rico's still on cooldown for a little while with his nades, so that's... Should have one, but he won't have the second. Yeah, they shut him down nicely at the apartment there. He didn't have his pocket medic.
So you're gonna have to forgive me, because I'm gonna be using the callouts that I published on Steam. But, Overwatch, just sort of above the wall where you have to plant, they have a FOB set up there, or a Skyhammer. So that's going to make it very difficult for them to sort of push up terrorists and stuff like that. He's able to keep them bled.
I love this spot. I would actually play there if I was any good at jumping.
Now it's very handy, you know how to switch around a little bit. So we got three going.
Oh, Volta with a triple.
Wow, that was huge. So that's two properly set up offensive players by atmosphere, wiped by RX. Pretty good so far.
We got Rika going for a suicide push. Got a little bit of time on the flag, but not enough.
So RX are going to have to keep it together here because they've gotten two clean wipes on atmosphere, but it also means that atmosphere can push in with fresh spawns and full teams. So if they come in with a good play, they'll be fine.
Infested. Oh, nice. Takes out Rico and TK's his own medic.
So they're making a bit of a play from the flag here, but RX just doing work around that flag. The crossfire is just, it's real. They took out Rico and his medic up at, oh, actually, we've got an offensive cheeky plan on that gen. Could disrupt atmosphere's rhythm here.
I think it's more to tell Redux if someone's coming that way, because they'll usually defuse it all the time.
Yeah.
Depending how quickly it is, if it's an NG or not. Oh, Lemon's rage quit.
So yeah, atmosphere playing with four now. Haven't called for pause. So I haven't got my CG password here. Very interesting they haven't paused as yet.
I'm not bloody riff. Pretty sure they changed the password for it, so I don't even know it. There we go.
So in terms of the first phase hold for RX here, I mean, they're going pretty well so far. Those first couple of spawn wipes, really, really great work, really great crossfire. Obviously some bad luck there for atmosphere though, with Lemtron DCing or crashing out, whatever happened.
Rage quit.
But possibly. But, actually, do we know how that plant went on the generator?
I'm not sure if that got defused. From what I see on my screen, which isn't much, it's been defused.
Okay. That's a nice little play by Zephyr there as well. He's just being a little bit cheeky. He's just sort of saying to atmosphere, hey, look, we've wiped you a couple of times. I've gone up on a planet generator. Now you've got to worry about that before you come and blow up my wall. So, obviously, like, a bit of confidence there from RX, which is good.
I reckon Max will swap it up to Artie soon. Get a bit more spam out rather than relying on that. Was it almost a 2 minute cooldown for the airstrike? Now they're bringing in Turismo.
Now this will be interesting. So we've got a pretty old school lineup here, and actually something we didn't mention before, like the people in the server right now, we've been in the scene for at least 10 years or so, like the majority of it. We've got Rico, Iceman, Max, Nadius, Witface, Zephyr, Volta, a lot of old schoolers in the server right now.
And if you're familiar with Cine, that's Magic June. But I don't think you are, that was long after you left.
Yeah, it seems like ET had a storied history after I left as well. I come back and a lot of people say these people did this, and I'm like, sorry, I can barely remember what I was there for.
Reckon atmosphere will change it up to something? If they fail, at least two more times?
I think even just their baseline offensive strat's pretty effective. So it's interesting that it hasn't actually got them very far at the moment. But in terms of changes from atmosphere, you don't know what to expect, because in terms of the loadouts, I don't know. Like, I never really would think, you know, someone like Max would go Kira. You know, not a good example for this map, but we haven't really seen a whole lot of change-ups from atmosphere so far. I mean, correct me if I'm wrong. I mean, I'm talking over the course of the series.
Yeah, they like to keep it one-dimensional. Might make the odd change, like Iceman was playing Phantom one of the games.
Yeah, and if it ain't broke, I mean, it's all good, but I guess if you're hitting a brick wall, you got to start looking at other options, but I think their basic strat will be good, as long as Max can get his airstrike out at a good time. They like to make a bit of a play by throwing the airstrike below the flag. That's not even just an atmosphere thing, that just seems to be the meta at the moment. And then sort of pushing out and either making a decision to go to flag or the wall, so... The loss of Lemtron though is pretty interesting.
I haven't seen Turismo play Dirty Bomb at all.
Well, I ran into him in a public server the other night and he was giving me a bit of shit about some shit I apparently said about 10 years ago, but which I had completely forgotten. But he has been on the pubs, so you know he knows a little bit of the rhythm and everything like that, so I don't think he's going to be anchoring or anything like that. I mean, obviously that's Rico's job. Alright, we'll have a game.
Yeah, we got Turismo on proxy, Frager, and Sniper. We'll probably be running double SMG proxy. Apartment's defense just got taken out.
Yep, and Rico's going up there with Native, so they can get apartments at the moment.
Rico's pushed up to defend his spawn at the moment.
So Rico's actually made a plan with two spawn nades on their spawn, but they spawned back, so those nades went nowhere. Now he's just gotten triple teamed by RX, but Nadius is there trying to clean up a bit up. So good work by Atmosphere, like they had four players and they still managed to get flagged. But now it's just going to come down to whether they can get this plant down.
That was a very quick fall in defense.
So yeah, I gotta say, great scramble by Atmosphere, especially being a player down, they managed to get the flag, but unfortunately no luck so far, and RX making a play for getting that flag, but Rico and Max gonna punish them though.
I'll be very surprised if they even attempt to go for the flag back anytime soon. They haven't got a plant down, so they don't need to worry about that. They have two in yellow, and their energy just went down.
Defensive turret down as well, so Turismo's going in for a plant. He likes to put a turret on his plants though, apparently. Looks like Turismo's have to come in as an engineer, which is going to hurt Atmosphere a little bit, because it seems like he hasn't got a lot of experience with
it. Ah, it's not that hard. See the objective, go plant it.
Yeah, if I can do it, anyone can do it.
So he's playing proxy, which is... Well, he doesn't have a choice, really. If only he had a spare nade, then he would've got a quad.
Really great play by Rico and Iceman there. They knew the plant was down, they knew they were going to be pushing left out of that high office. They got in their face, bought a lot of time. There's just no chance of a defuse anymore.
Yeah, it's got like 2 seconds left on it.
So RX, pretty confident play again. They know they can set up for this sort of middle fade. So they can bleed a bit of time here, be good. Rico going YOLO, no luck. Max, again, gets cut up by this crossfire. They got the turret, they got two on the right. And yeah, that's almost a wipe. Iceman on lock. Actually, yeah, take that back, he's gonna get rid of it. So the thing about this is if RX don't kill back, they'll have Atmosphere spawn in their face.
Oh yeah, because they just spawned just outside that wall now, don't they?
Yeah.
They all slashed out.
Still great play by Atmosphere there, because they didn't even leave that many to just kill out, because they killed them all anyway.
Max is on long from a sentry. Turret. Medpack dropped. Now they got revived. Never mind. Got three going up to the side road, two main.
Pretty standard setup by RX, you're looking at two above those escalators, like what you call the balcony area or cafe, as you mentioned in the last car. We've got a defensive turret over there on the low left hand side, a couple of guys milling around.
Do you reckon that sentry you put up on the, I don't know what they're called, containers I guess, over near cafe? near where the objective is, rather than the front door.
So as you come out the right hand side, low there.
Yeah, near Ghost Tunnel.
Yeah, left. It's pretty handy. Yeah. Pretty handy.
The one on top of the crates at main's pretty good. Rico's taking over MG platform.
So Atmosphere just completely staged their offense. They've got it all good. They've got a spawn nade on Volta. Rico doing work. He's taking out two now.
You got Whitface back up in the MG.
So I actually have two up right now. One plant down, another one going up. And Rico's getting nice and set up for his little spawn camp.
It's a nice nade on Iceman.
Two down for RX, two plants down, three guys left. Defuse looking hot.
Thank you kindly.
They know they have some work ahead of them here, and they know they got Rico to worry about, so looking for an alternative route to get down to those plants.
Oh, unlucky. Hello.
Is that?
Give the medic as well. Get it?
Unfortunately. It was looking good, but then, yep, the crossfire came.
Charisma made all the difference. Came in. Did they just instantly lose first phase?
Pretty much. So that's pretty good considering like the amount of time Turismo's played versus Lemtron.
That was a pretty good first phase by Redux. For a while, anyway. They held it very strong, very well.
Yeah, can't disagree with that. Pretty impressed by some plays there, but unfortunately when it got to that second phase, like, they played it pretty well. They had a nice first phase defense. They bled a bit of time with the mid-phase defense, they got back to the last phase, and it just took about two offensive pushes from Atmosphere to clean it up, so...
Maybe a bit more practice for them on second phase, in their scrims. Mm-hmm. Yeah, it's all the same on both sides, two medics, the soldier, NG, FOPs. Don't want to see any changes there.
So yeah, it's pretty much the exact same loadout for both teams on offense and defense right now.
Nice prediction made by Rico.
So Rico's down for a half spawn here. They got two staging up on the turret, but they're a little bit weak.
Here, pick this up.
That's a nice and odious to give Whitface a free med pack.
He's a giving guy, let's be honest. So that was a little bit unfortunate there for RX. They had two guys, they had guys up in the apartments. They could have kept it, they didn't. They tried to just sort of push the pace a little bit. And now, looking at almost a lot.
Cheers.
The guy's not going as well as he used to. Especially with the LMG. That was enough practice? Or it's just too big of a change from the M4?
It's interesting that he's chosen to go LMG. It's not something that I would have expected from him, but I'm guessing it's relating to the recent buffs, nerfs, changes, whatever, from patches that he's managed to make the move. But yes, interesting choice for sure. I guess he's probably anticipating a lot more close quarters fights, both in the apartments where he is right now and also in the second phase defense, so that's probably why he's opted for the LMG.
I think Redux will swap up to a sniper soon, try and break this defense, get a couple of good picks.
So we're looking at something pretty similar here. We got a guy who actually, no, we got a big push on luggage, but Iceman's up high on what we call Overwatch, which is where the FOPs or the Skyhammer was in the last round. So if he manages to get ammo up there somehow, he'll be pretty effective, but yeah, it's just gonna slice up anyone going luggage.
Yeah, well, it looks like he can easily throw it up there.
Probably you're too kind.
So this is looking pretty... I would say bad for our... Well, after a 2 minute nade by Rico, I could take that back, but... They had a really nice first push. They got two guys at the apartments, but they gave it up too quickly. They could have staged off that a lot better than what they did, and now they're looking at full setups from Atmosphere. And a bit of a rebuttal plan on that generator from Turismo. So if they manage to get that generator blown...
Certainly could cuts get your choices down. Either go main or you go main.
Volta doing some great work to take out Rico in close quarters. Skyhammer versus LMG frag.
Volta, please, just that good. Better than the superstar Rico.
So RX, they have a pop. Can they keep it?
A little fight in yellow as well. Cleared out yellow with a medic who can possibly slow plan it.
Got bullets for you.
Got taken out. Now he's on a long spawn.
So Atmosphere have their full setup back in place yet again. We've got a push coming in, left luggage, but it's tough. Atmosphere have an answer for whatever RX are gonna do here. If they wanna go for the flag, they've got them covered from apps, they got them covered from Overwatch. If they want to go from luggage and then down through the disco to get the plant, or yellow as you said, they get sliced from Overwatch again. So they really need to work for a couple of picks here so they can get some penetration.
They've changed it up to a nader at the moment. A bit
definitely
more spammage. They changed the health on her recently, didn't they? Get back down to 100.
I don't know if she got a speed nerf or a health nerf or...
Know,
it was something.
It was a speed nerf then.
So RX opting to push low for apartment. So they take out Nate. But Rico...
Rico's just there.
He's just there. He is, isn't he? A Rico LMG to the face isn't something I'd want to experience anytime soon. So Rico got a bit cheeky there. He's on a half spawn now. He tried to get a nice little spawn nade, but he paid the price. So they could make a nice play for apartments here, but... Iceman over there on Overwatch. He managed to suppress them in apartments even if they get it, so... So they got three guys set up in apartments right now. Spawn just ticked over.
Nadius is down for a long spawn, so is Turismo. Yeah. There we go, they finally give them. Iceman's down at Overwatch.
RX have done some damage here, but they need to capitalize. What the man can take out Max? Like, that's not an easy top.
It's gonna be put on a long spawn shortly, though.
Unfortunately, couldn't get the spawn camp. And he's on long, as you mentioned. The play for flag is coming up. But if Rico gets wind of that, it's not gonna be pretty. They have spawned forward, so the spawns have been set. Max is standing there trying to get the flag back for the defense. But if RX can wipe him and get that plant, they can at least get through the first objective, but even then it'd be a tough ask for the second.
Rico's sitting up at apartments at the moment. Better get backraged. He's down for a long spawn. Got your med pack right here.
So yeah, despite Rico being down, it's a lot of hard work to get down and get that plant.
What is it, like 50 seconds for the dino?
It is, so...
If they even get to that point?
You know, it's pretty much mathematically impossible at this point. Travel time, dino plants, so... Atmosphere have taken out this first map for sure.
Well, Wolf players do differently here. Oh, 4 minutes ago.
Well, I'd tell you, James, but I'd have to kill you, man.
Alright, what if I pay?
Thanks a lot.
Mate's right. In terms of the first phase offense, I think... Zephyr identified a couple of things and he tried to make a couple of little change-ups here to break it open, but unfortunately he just didn't get lucky. Atmosphere has some hot aims, and with that crossfire, especially from Overwatch by Iceman, you really have to have a couple more counterplayers to sort of deal with that, but I think Zephyr had the right idea. He brought in an Nader. Unfortunately, just couldn't, you know, create the opportunity.
I think it's just a matter of being outskilled.
I think there's a couple of things for this particular matchup. I mean, Atmosphere, obviously, you know, considered the best team in Australia at the moment, and Dirty Bomb, for various reasons. IRX have, they've been on the ropes a little bit with less sort of lineup changes and having to pick up a couple of players here and there. And, you know, obviously you look at Atmosphere, you see Max, multiple championship winner, you see Rico, multiple championship winner, Iceman, leader of multiple championship team, and Nadius and Turismo have rolled with those guys for a while, so...
Hey, it's just a champion gamer, really.
It's a lot to contend with, and you really need a lot of confidence to go up a team against a team like that. And with the position that RX has been in, I mean, especially with having to delay the game due to sort of player unavailability, yeah, they're definite underdog.
Frank. Oh yeah, there's no doubt. There's a massive hill they needed to go up this game. They didn't have the altitude training for it.
That's it.
Team Atmosphere take the first map. Fairly comfortable. What do we got? Volta and Fleet, 22-29, 18-24. Rico, Max, 50-24, 26-15. Who are you going to give MVP to this map?
Oh, that's a good question.
Look, ignore Rico, because he's the obvious one.
I don't know, I think I'm a fan of what Zephyr was doing, sort of the way he was trying to break open Atmosphere, but yeah, probably Max, because, you know, he used to be a Mo player, so got a bit of bias there.
I'd probably say Witface. She's fraying quite well the whole game.
So Witface is what, though, is it?
Yeah.
Yeah. No, I did a bit of specking with Watder, and yeah, he was doing some good work as a fragger for sure. Very well played. So even though, you know, RX couldn't break open the first phase defense of Atmosphere on Terminal, they also had a really nice first phase defense themselves, just unfortunate they couldn't get the second phase set up. Maybe could have put a bit more time to... a bit more breathing room on their attack. So it's interesting that RX have... like, I'm guessing this is RX's map pick. Since Zephyr's just said train. So that's definitely known as one of Atmosphere's better maps. So it's interesting that they've opted to go for that one. So hopefully they've got a bit of a plan for it.
Choosing Train Yard for a second map. Is this Redux's home map or what?
Well, no, I'd say it's Atmosphere's, if anybody's. Considering they had a nice win over Avant-Garde on it, I think that sort of let them claim it as their map.
Iceman's running Phantom. Better use it or I'm going to abuse him after the game.
As you should.
Got bullets for you.
Turismo's pulled out the sniper, perhaps? What a... is that the water? No, that's Felix. Well, he's using that one over the default sniper. MOA or...
I'd probably just say... it might even just come down to what cards he has available to him.
True.
He hasn't really been scrimming that much, so I doubt he would have sort of made the investment to purchase a certain card. But we're going live already.
Yep, map 2, train yard. We have 2 medics, soldier, sniper, NG. Defenders are running 2 medics, fops, soldier, and NG. It's got fleet for a bit. Who is apparently Whipface's brother.
Yeah, so, you know. Hopefully they got some good synergy going. Looks like a 4-man push to the left, as in the old ammo sub. So something happened there. It must have been a really good read from Atmosphere that there was going to be a 4 ammo push. Rico was there with his M4, just ready to do some work.
Yeah, I think Turismo spotted them. Made the call on the first push.
Yeah, makes sense.
He was the one that was waiting the most in the riverbed while the sniper was taking shots at him. He's got guts like that. Stand out in the open for the sniper. Someone had to be the bait.
So Rico is obviously, he's opted to go back to the M4 for this map because it has a lot more long range fight.
He's got more experience with it, I guess.
Yeah.
That's unfortunate, I would have been triple nade if he threw that correctly.
Yeah, unfortunately with that, Nadius shoots Rico in the face. Seems to be having a bit of a conversation there.
Lovers dispute?
Possibly.
I think
I'd probably shoot Rico in the face if he missed a 3-man nade too.
Just chuck him on the bench. I think he was trying to take out Revive, but he threw a medpack at him beforehand. Got your medpack
right here. Yeah.
And the medpack was still ticking on the first hit.
Rico's been longed. RX has taken the MG side of the map, it looks like. I take that back, they've got one dude, and he's down. So, came down to a 2-on-2, and Atmosphere come in on top on that one.
Yeah, Zeph was on the backhand side, going up the back entrance towards the door that you can build. You got back rage from there.
On that one.
Yeah, Zeph was on the backhand side, going up the back entrance towards the door that you can build. You got back rage from there.
So Arax are opting for taking control of the MG house. There's been a lot of, discussion on whether this is actually the best way to attack this phase.
That MG,
we know Rico's
quite gonna
be heavier. Yeah, that's true. It's just, I don't know, if you can take that MG house and set up a nice camp, then go for it. But if you can take the MG house but can't get control of the right-hand side over the ammo side and get the plant down, it doesn't really do you much good. Pretty much you can get pincered from their spawn and the opposite side of the map. Shout out to Ice.
I feel Nora would do quite well on this stage if she was just holding MG.
Yeah, it definitely wouldn't hurt. Blitzlock isn't bad at range. I mean, obviously it's better at range than it is at close quarters, so definitely contribute over the other side of the map of the Nora.
Although that direct hit health bonus that you get from Sawbones is very helpful. So you get plus 20 on direct hit instantly.
Okay. So it looks like Atmosphere pretty much going full no respect here. Rico getting up in their face. Really close quarters on this. He gets taken down. We've got a combo frag of Sawbones going to MG. But the call's been made, so Crossfire's running down from mid.
Gonna catch a nade in the face shortly.
And yeah, it looks like a probably a 3-1-1 split. We have one attacker in the old ammo house.
Face takes out the medic in, Rico.
I'm reloaded.
I think he intentionally took out his medic. Just trying to hit Rico with it. Long 15 second spawn, 4-3 of redux. Iceman's down to 10. They did get the plant down.
And nobody called it.
Yeah, I don't get these pop-ups.
Professionals.
I don't get these pop-ups. They don't work for me.
Me either. I blame Precious HUD personally. But the plant went down, which is really nice by RX, but the defuse obviously came in, so they're back to square one. They haven't got the gate built. And not much to show for what they've done so far.
Is that gate pretty critical to attack?
Well, the meta seems to be, you know, sort of build up that gate, take control of that side of the map, and then, you know, suppress them coming from this point. But, there are a lot of options on the map, but that's definitely a cookie cutter strat for the train yard phase went off in.
Zef managed to plant another one, but he got taken out instantly. Defuse. Turismo's got his iPhone out and defusing it.
Yeah, he definitely wasn't crushing candy on that thing.
Reload.
So yeah, RX getting scrapped. I mean, Zef's obviously gotten a couple of ninja plants, but even with their loadout right now and positioning, there's really not a lot that they can do to try and hold those plants, so...
They had an Ardy or even a Kira, they can put that down on it. For Kira, you put it on the plant and you... How long has a Kira beam last for? What, 5-7 seconds?
Some huge amount of time. It feels like an eternity when you want to get a defuse.
And you can call that in from spawn, I believe. Just about getting the right angle.
Yeah, I haven't managed to do that one myself, but I've been told about it.
Zef's got another plant down.
Let's see what he can do. He's there on his own with a Keck 10. He's taking out an engineer and a turret. Wants to back rage max, but he hasn't got bullets. I don't know, he was looking for options. Couldn't find any.
Got another 30 seconds on it.
Turismo coming gate side. But he's got a bullet to the face. Volta and a Cine. They don't want to make this happen.
Iceman being all up in their face. Iceman punished for it.
It was a nice play though. It's
about 10 seconds left on the plant.
And you know, this is good. They've got the first phase plant down. They've managed to hold it. Yeah, even though the gate wasn't built, they rocked up there and they shot the engineer in the face, so that's a plus. But they got some work ahead of them trying to get the next two phases. So loadout-wise, still nothing changing on the atmosphere side. Bushwhacker, Fragger, Skyhammer, Sawsaw. Offensively, exactly the same thing.
I reckon they'll bring out Nader soon enough. They need a hot. No, that's our injury actually. Never
mind. You mean Turtle? Or Javelin?
You won't be seeing Javelin anytime in the next 5 years.
I wish. Yeah, I think Nader's a bit of a weird one for offense on this fade. You really gotta try and read the play and see what opportunity you want to try to create. Nader's toolkit. It's a bit different on this map.
I reckon it's pretty good, but their Nader is also their NG.
Yeah.
Unless they want to change Volt to the NG, who's running Fletcher at the moment off. He's currently on FOBs. Yeah. If you get the plant in the right spot, you can actually Nader it from the other side of the wall. That's more gimmicky than reliable.
Sounds like something 40 would do.
Rest in peace, 40.
Hey, probably kindred spirits with him, both rifle nade nerds.
Just accidental nade there, Rico. You didn't throw that like that.
You just say you planned it.
Got your med pack right here. I'm changing mag. Thanks.
So, they're getting some good reads defensively. Their forward squatting's allowing them to rotate Rico through underground to hit them if they push down underground. But as I say, Rico meets their fragger, he meets their medic. Takes the fragger down, but he gets rid of it. But Rico has the answer. Oh,
he can shoot through this part. See, but that grill section that watches over that staircase, you can shoot through that rather than going out in the open like he was.
Yeah, I don't see enough of that actually. A lot of people just wait for them to turn that corner. So it's a bit interesting how Atmosphere set this up. You'd initially see, you know, like the Fragger, Sawbones combo on the right hand side of the map, but they're using it to do a lot more sort of reactions and stuff from the left.
Trismo comes in with the back rage, gets a medic and fops.
And it's almost a clean wipe of RX.
Frag you right up!
Rico was trying to get a Witface on the long spawn. Or anyone.
Yeah, it was that. Bit of fragger on fragger crime there, almost, but no one came out on top. As I say that, Rico gets in the face of the fragger and medic, but gets taken down, so that's the second time Rico's gone 2v1 against Fleet and Wotduck, or Witface, which I think you said they're the brothers, right?
Yep.
And the fragger goes down, but the medic cleans it up. But we have a plant down.
Yep, that's halfway
on
done at
the objective.
Halfway defused.
And we got one dude left alive from Marek.
He's on a bad angle at the moment.
Ooh!
Doesn't matter
nice
if you got a grenade.
This guy will not give up. What the going? Huge clutch nade, clutch kick. He needs the rest of his team.
This guy's they're right behind him.
They
need
to
rush in there.
Plant. Atmosphere trying to get in, they just need to tickle it, they just need to just even just breathe on it and they go defuse. But
RX said
no, no, you will not defuse my fucking dynamite, get the fuck out, they've blown. So really good work there from RX, definitely, and Witface going absolutely huge with the clutch nade, and also the kill on Iceman, like, you wouldn't expect it.
Oh, that cheeky sentry. Skill. That is Turismo.
Yeah, he's a bit of a cheeky one, that guy.
Still no changes in the lineup yet.
Yeah, these guys are just, they're happy with what they're playing, and, you know, if it's working, then that's all good.
It's a long-range node on max.
But Rico refusing to sit back, he's just getting in their face the whole time. And the reality is, even if he does get taken down by a combo, he's delayed them, he's you know, bled them for time, so... That's actually not gaining RX much ground.
Zip just hanging around spawn at the moment, I think he's waiting for the docks to be returned. To heaven.
So Zeph's rolling out the nade up. He knows he needs to try something different. And you obviously don't really need a bushwhacker for this phase, so that makes sense. No sniper coming in from RX.
Guess they weren't feeling comfortable with it.
No, they've got the red eye, they've got two Vasilis, but yeah, nothing.
Who played sniper last round? It was Cine, wasn't it?
I don't think I saw a sniper coming in from RX at all. We saw Turismo, I think, one with the Felix. But,
It's bloody Fleet. Played sniper right at the start.
Oh, really? I'm too busy just, you know, being a complete Rico fan, seeing what he's up to. It's like watching poetry in motion. Fire support on it. So full hold. Despite some nice plays from RX, they weren't able to get even one of the objectives capped. So all Atmosphere have to do here to win is complete those objectives in a faster time. They don't even have to actually cap anything else on the last phase.
Yeah, a lot of clutch players that round. I didn't get to see who played into the train though. Probably Zeph,
and then Witchface came in and sort of made it work. So, you know, you're seeing some great potential from RX. Obviously, Atmosphere are pretty well drilled, especially on this map, so it's definitely a hard ask to get faster times on those objectives versus Atmosphere. So, do you reckon Iceman's going to roll a Phantom for this one?
I probably will in the last few minutes. If he doesn't, I'm going to cry myself to sleep.
Well, you know, mate. You can do that anyway, Volk. Come on, mate.
I do, but I just need an excuse.
Yeah, that's true. So, Atmosphere with a proxy. Nice to see her getting a bit of a whirl.
He's probably running the double SMG build. Card.
Like fast forward 2 years, you'll be able to buy it a bloody Akimbo proxy.
Yeah. Redux has been completely wiped for that, they just respawned.
So the brother combo gets taken down this time by Rico. And he's back in his home ground with Nadius, where they usually defend. Walter and Cine unfortunately taken down as well. So Atmosphere pretty much made the play, got the plant, and now it's just spawn camp and get to next fate. Looks like RX are already staging for a fallback. Actually, I'm gonna say that they're looking to push Canal under the bridge, but it's not gonna do them much good. Probably just gonna see what they can do in the last remaining second.
Probably got 5 seconds left on though, I guess. They need to slash out and get ready for the next part. Or if they haven't already slashed.
So I think in Dirty Cup's rules, that would be a win. Not that that exists anymore. But CG tend to do things a bit different.
We like to stand out from the others.
Yeah, that's one way to put it. But, RX have managed to set up their defense. But can they hold out against Atmosphere?
Fortunately, Turismo is using a shoddy build, which isn't going to bode well for this map.
Is he using the Founder's proxy?
No.
Interesting choice.
Is he in the Alpha with us?
Thank you.
I don't think he was.
Whichever way you're looking at it, Atmosphere have the house, they have they have two dudes in the carrot. Witchface is back. And he takes out Mac. He just loves this train carriage, man. You put him near that train carriage, he's gonna do work. So cheeky airstrike coming in from Vault, hopefully to take a bit of a delay, but it's a bit of a TK. Thankfully short spawn.
Yeah, that was the whole intention for it. He wanted to make sure he made spawn.
Yeah, for sure. I know, some players on my team, it's like I TK them to get them to bloody slash kill for spawn.
Oh, is that so, you? Unaided someone? Anyway.
I love unaided people, mate. Teammates, enemies, any holes they've got. So they've got that dark house.
They've cleared out the train sector. It's got a plan on it.
Yep. Atmosphere at the plant. So it looks like atmosphere. They're fully set up to hold this plant, but the reinforced wave from RX is coming in. So let's see what they can do.
I kind of wish Turismo had his SMG built. The result is shoddy, but like I said, he probably didn't have the card for it.
Yeah, that's my guess. You wouldn't really want to bring out a shotgun to this map. And that's gonna blow. Unfortunately, the dream's over for the carriage and Whitfed. And then it's third fed.
That's technically it, isn't it?
I believe so. So we got 10 minutes of time here. It looks like they're gonna play out. So atmosphere will know they got a lot of breathing room. So we're going to see exactly how serious they take.
Rico's heading to MG at the moment. Bit of back raise damage on Cine.
So his Pell Nagus is coming. Yeah, they're playing that nice, so Rico was on the MG, he didn't care if he got killed because he knew he had nades with him, but Rico doesn't really care about the bridge. He cares about spawn nades, and he's set up for one now.
Yeah, he's looking through the crack to see where they're going.
He's definitely a crack watcher. He gets Volt up, doesn't do it with a nade though, but he's going for the anal on. Oh, direct teabag to Volta's face coming in from Rico. Thank you. I don't know if that's cricket, man. But it happened. We all saw it.
It's a 10-match ban there for Rico. Sportsman-like right. Behavior.
And that's a complete spawn camp from Atmosphere. So, you know, they came into this game, they had a bit of a shaky start on the first phase terminal, but they definitely warmed up and now they're just playing it pub spawn camp style, which a bit disrespectful, but you know.
Gives Turismo breathing room to win the map for them.
Yeah, I reckon. But yeah, as I say that, they probably just needed to kill them to get time to sort of relay those objectives over, but you know. Definitely good play from Atmosphere. I think it was definitely some nice attempts there from Redux to sort of pull things back here and there, but unfortunately Atmosphere too strong.
And we got Rico and Max, 58 and 25, 40 and 18. Fleet and Volta, 19-32, 17-44. Atmosphere win that pretty comfortably, 2-0. I'm not really sure who they play next.
Yeah, I think it'll probably be Integral Nation or someone. I know Wolf players, we have Redux next week, and then we have Integral Nation and then Atmosphere, so yeah, it'll be interesting to see how they go next. But I think a lot of Atmosphere have a lot of their harder games out of the way in this series. Ascension, Thank God, etc. But yeah, it should be interesting.
All right.